Ramipril is an ACE inhibitor used for the management of hypertension and the reduction of cardiovascular mortality following myocardial infarction in hemodynamically stable patients with clinical signs of congestive heart failure. It is recommended that it be used for as short a period as possible and at a low dose. In this video, let's find found. What is Ramipril? What is Ramipril used for? Contraindication. What are the side effects of taking Ramipril? How does Ramipril work? How to use Ramipril? What is Ramipril? Ramipril, sold under the brand name Altace among others, is an ACE inhibitor type medication used to treat high blood pressure, heart failure, and diabetic kidney disease. It can also be used as a preventative medication in patients over 55 years old to reduce the risk of having a heart attack, stroke, or cardiovascular death in patients shown to be at high risk, such as some diabetics and patients with vascular disease. It is a reasonable initial treatment for high blood pressure. Ramipril was patented in 1981 and approved for medical use in 1989. It is available as a generic medication. In 2020, it was the 196th most commonly prescribed medication in the United States, with more than 2 million prescriptions. What is Ramipril used for? For the management of mild to severe hypertension. May be used to reduce cardiovascular mortality following myocardial infarction in hemodynamically stable individuals who develop clinical signs of congestive heart failure within a few days following myocardial infarction. To reduce the rate of death, myocardial infarction, and stroke in individuals at high risk of cardiovascular events. May be used to slow the progression of renal disease in individuals with hypertension, diabetes mellitus, and microalbuminuria or overt nephropathy. What is Ramipril used for? For the management of mild to severe hypertension. May be used to reduce cardiovascular mortality following myocardial infarction in hemodynamically stable individuals who develop clinical signs of congestive heart failure within a few days following myocardial infarction. To reduce the rate of death, myocardial infarction, and stroke in individuals at high risk of cardiovascular events. May be used to slow the progression of renal disease in individuals with hypertension, diabetes mellitus, and microalbuminuria or overt nephropathy. Side effects. Ramipril use can result in shaking, dry cough, dizziness and lightheadedness due to low blood pressure. Fatigue, especially in the early stages. Mouth dryness in the early stages. Nausea. Fainting. Signs of infection, example, fever, chills, persistent sore throat. Chest pain. Neutropenia, low white blood cells. Impotence, erectile dysfunction. Hyperkalemia. Pharmacodynamic. It is an inactive prodrug that is converted to ramiprilat in the liver, the main site of activation, and kidneys. Ramiprilat confers blood pressure-lowering effects by antagonizing the effect of the RAAS. The RAAS is a homeostatic mechanism for regulating hemodynamics, water, and electrolyte balance. During sympathetic stimulation or when renal blood pressure or blood flow is reduced, renin is released from the granular cells of the juxtaglomerular apparatus in the kidneys. In the bloodstream, renin cleaves circulating angiotensinogen to ATI, which is subsequently cleaved to ATII by ACE. ATII increases blood pressure using a number of mechanisms. Mechanism of action. Ramipril inhibits the RAAS system by binding to and inhibiting ACE, thereby preventing the conversion of angiotensin I to angiotensin II. As plasma levels of angiotensin II fall, less activation of the G-protein-coupled receptors angiotensin receptor I, at 1R, and angiotensin receptor II, at 2R, occurs. At 1R mediates vasoconstriction, inflammation, fibrosis, and oxidative stress through a variety of signaling pathways. These include GQ coupling to the inositol triphosphate pathway, activation of phospholipases C, A2, and D, which contribute to eicosanoid production, activation of CA2 plus dependent and MAP kinases, GI and G12/13, and eventual activation of the JAK/STAT pathway, leading to cell growth and production of extracellular matrix components. AT1R activation also leads to increased activity of membrane-bound NADH/NADPH oxidase, which contributes to production of reactive oxygen species. Decreased activation of this receptor mediates the renoprotective, antihypertensive, and cardioprotective effects of ramipril by reducing inflammation and vasoconstriction. Half-life. Initial rapid decline represents distribution into tissues and has a half-life of 2 to 4 hours. The half-life of the apparent elimination phase is 9 to 18 hours, which is thought to represent clearance of free drug. Dose. The dose of this medicine will be different for different patients. Hypertension. Initial, not on diuretic, 2.5 mg, POQ-day. Initial, with diuretic 1.25 mg, POQ-day. Maintenance, February 5, 20 mg/day, POQ-day, or divided Q12-HR. Heart failure, post-myocardial infarction. Stable patients with CHF signs within a few days of acute MI. Initial, 2.5 mg POQ12HR, may titrate to 5 mg POQ12HR, decrease to 1.25 mg Q12HR if hypotension occurs, monitor for greater than 2 hours after initial dose, and reduce concomitant diuretic if hypotension occurs. Maintenance, after 1 week, increase dose, if tolerated, to target dose of 5 mg Q12HR. Safety advice. US FDA pregnancy category D, there is positive evidence of human fetal risk based on adverse reaction data from investigational or marketing experience or studies in humans, but potential benefits may warrant use of the drug in pregnant women despite potential risks. That's all the information about ramipril we collected. Thanks for listening. Do not forget to like, share, and subscribe for the HeInfo channel if you like this video to update more health information.